Begin by saying how much I love this conference. So typically I'm going to academic conferences and you give a talk and it's so polished and everyone is sitting there and they're very polite. And then someone comes up, asks a question, and it's just a softball question, and inevitably the speaker has a slide at the end of their deck that they didn't get to answer the question, right? Completely boring. Here, when someone gets up there and they say something that you don't agree with, people call you on right there, which is great. I think it's just a fantastic medium. The lightning talk I'm going to give today is some work that's completely unrelated to the in-GIMP stuff that I've been talking about. This is work that was done by Richard Fung, who's a master student of mine. So this right here is an acceleration curve for a mouse, okay? So this is essentially defining a function to manipulate what's called the control display gain, okay? So when you move the mouse at a certain speed, it's going to move the cursor at a certain speed. And what this curve right here is saying is the faster you move the mouse, then the faster the cursor is actually going to move in real life. Okay? Or, sorry, on the screen. Okay? So we've taken this idea, we've generalized it, and then turned it into an end user tool within a drawing application. Okay? So for this, I need a volunteer. All right, come on up, Simon. So this right here is KineMac templates. What I'm going to do, first of all, is I'm going to put down a hatching template. Come on down. All right. It's like an infomercial. Yes. Okay. So
this is great.
So exactly. So what I want you to do is, first of all, try to do things like draw a circle here in the blank space.
All right. May I have a mouse?
No. No.
Okay.
Got to use the trackpad. So now try to draw that same circle there in that template.
Whoa.
Whoa. Okay. So that's his reaction. So now try to draw a diagonal line that starts out and then goes into it. All right, so can you explain the feeling, the sensation of what's happening?
Well, it feels like resistance it's obviously some kind of scaling in the y direction or something like that, but...
Right, so it's attenuating his movement in the y direction. So I'm going to go over here to the hatching thing, and I'm going to turn this up to 100%, okay? And now I want you to go and try to draw a diagonal line through that same template. So now he's drawing pretty much a perfectly straight line, okay? So I asked you to draw a circle before. That's your circle right there. I can't really draw better circles than that, but this is kind of typical when you're working with a trackpad or a mouse. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in a compass template, all right? And now what I'd like you to do is to draw a circle in that template around the center of it. Ooh, look at that. So much better. Right? So did you feel a difference when you were drawing that circle?
Yeah, it was easy.
Cool. Thanks. All right, so give Simon a round of applause. Thanks.
Okay.
Yep. I'll take it from here. So what we're doing, if it's not entirely obvious, is these templates are attenuating your movement. They're influencing the cursor as you're using the cursor. But what's notable about this is that they're preserving the features of freehand input, right? He just drew a circle there that was much, much better than the circle he drew freehand, but it still preserves the human elements. So this is one of the goals of this research, was to come up with these drawing aids that allow you to draw better, but still preserve the human element. So those are a couple templates right there. Let me show you a few more, and then I'll show you some results. From an artist. Okay, so all those templates you just saw right there, they help you draw as you're drawing. So they only influence the cursor when you're moving it. So this right here is a grid template. So if I try to draw a circle right there, it looks like that. Within the grid template, when I try to draw a circle, you'll see that it's now trying to assist you in creating straight lines in the vertical and horizontal axes. Okay. Let's get rid of that and switch over to active templates. So like I said, all those were influencing your cursor in the moment as you're using the as you're using your cursor. This right here, all I'm going to do is press the mouse button down. All right? So this particular template is putting a force on the cursor. Okay? So if I were to start outside and then move in, you see right there, it catches it and pushes it. Okay? So now I'm going to get, I'll show you another example. This is a magnetic point. All right? And I'm going to reduce the strength in this to about 25%. I'm going to go over here. I'm going to click within it, and you'll see it draws it in. Okay? So it's attracting it. Now I'm going to go and put this over here. And exactly, it's going to draw a spiral. Okay, so the templates now act with one another, right? So you can create these compositions of the templates to get these new types of tools. So let's go back to the hatching template that we had before. Let's just overlay that on top. And you know this is the first thing you would do too, is like, how many can I put on top and what's the effect going to be? All right? And so now when I do this, you can see right there, it's flattening it a bit because it's attenuating your movement in the y-axis. Right, so the stronger I make that particular template, the more it's going to influence the cursor and flatten it. So really, these tools right here constitute a brand new set of drawing aids that we've never seen before. Again, where the goal is to help improve your output while retaining the human element. So that's the tool. I'm going to show you quickly how you implement this. So it's actually, at the root of it, it's very simple. So you start out and you continually pull the cursor, okay? And you get your delta x and delta y from the last time. That's your start. And then you want to derive a new delta x and delta y, okay? So our tool is this function, this mapping function, from there to there. All right, so you have this equation right here. Here's your delta x and delta y. So this is the change that's being observed in the mouse. Okay, we can attenuate that with a scaling factor, or we can add something to it. And this is where you have your active templates, where it's actually imparting a force on the cursor. Okay, so the really simple example, we start out with the hatching. We take the same equation. We set the scaling of x to 1, so the x is preserved. But then we take the scaling of y, and we only take 10% of the movement in the y-axis. Okay? And so in this particular example right here, you'll see that you'll be able to draw horizontal lines more easily, but there's a simple transform that can be produced so that you can, you know, have your parallel lines at any angle. Okay? And in this case, we would have our constants over here set to 0, right? Because we don't want to impart any force on the cursor. For this one right here, so this is a template that will push your cursor to the right, and so we keep S, X, and SY as 1, and then we just add a constant amount to the X constant so that it will push the cursor, okay? And you can take all these things, so these are in Cartesian coordinates, you can easily transform them into polar coordinates, and then you get things like the compass template, which helps you draw better circles. So here are some examples drawn with this particular tool. So this is the actual input that was coming in from the Wacom tablet from an artist using it. But this is actually what they saw, right? So you can see right here the templates are cleaning up the strokes. You see better curves. You see better straight lines. But you still see that there's a human element to it, right? So it's improving the output while maintaining the human element, right? Another example, so right here, he drew this... robotic-like character or warrior character, however you want to describe it. Again, you can see that the strokes here are much cleaner in the output compared to what was actually being read in. And the artist said, you know, it's great because what I can do is I can be faster, I can work faster, I don't have to think as hard, but I still have control, right? So he still felt like he was in control. It's just the tool is just giving him a hand so he could work faster. And then this is a final result right here. Which shows you some of the possibilities that can be achieved with this particular tool. So you see right here a bunch of concentric circles. These are things that you could do with a tool like Inkscape, or you could do it freehand by GIMP. But it would take a certain amount of time to achieve that type of regularity. But it would also be very difficult to do it. You know, if you did it by hand, you'd have to be very careful to have these lines and to make concentric circles about a singular point. If you use a tool like an ellipse tool, you're going to lose the human element. So that's it. Thanks.
What software is this?
So this is stuff that we built. If people are interested in implementing this, we'd love to hear from you.
Is it possible to show the templates that you put on the drawings?
Yes, so they are, it may not be, they're right there, you can see them right there.
Yeah, but I'm wondering, like, how much templates you have to define, like with the drawing, the block, and things like that, like...
Okay. So if we look at something like this right here, where you have concentric circles, you only have a template there, like in the top right for these concentric circles. You just define a big one, and then you're going to be able to draw anywhere within it. Okay. One of the versions we have of the software, we allowed you to use two mice, and so the non-dominant hand controlled the template and its position. So you could define a template, grab it, move it around on the composition with your non-dominant hand, and then draw with your dominant hand.
What exactly does it take to create a new kinematic template?
So we actually created a Python binding to it, so you could write Python functions to create a new template. And the interface to that would be you get a delta x and delta y in, and you just spit out a new delta x and delta y. Mm-hmm. So it's pretty much that easy. The one complication, the one thing that makes this kind of hard to do, is that you have to hide the system cursor for this right now, right? Because we're altering the mapping of the control display gain, right? So we're altering that mapping between the physical input device and then what the user sees on the screen. And we can't get low level enough to do this at the operating system right now, or at least we haven't tried it. So what we do is we hide the system cursor and then we draw our own cursor while the mouse is down.
I think my question goes in a similar direction. The problem with this I see right at the moment is that you have to constantly redefine your templates to get to a result that you're actually interested in. From the visual basic section, this kind of reminds me of vector fields, where you have like directions and stuff like this. Have you considered let the user draw something and use this drawing input as an input for redefining the template. So, for example, for hatching patterns, you could start with any line, and then it would be easy to follow this line and draw parallels to this line and stuff like this.
No, definitely, that came out of our user trials with this. That would be a good thing to have. You know, let them rough out the edges and then use those as the boundaries. I think you could also do things. So, one of the things we played with was you read in a bitmap image, you do some basic computer vision processing of it to, for example, define the edges of that and then use that as your initial set of templates. But the one thing that we did find that we weren't expecting is that the artists started using these to help rough out the drawing. And so they would just throw a bunch of templates on the canvas to represent the different parts of the scene that they were going to draw. And so in some sense, they were roughing out the scene with the templates, and then they would also use the templates as kind of like a tracing guide. Yeah?
This is really cool. I've seen this sort of thing before. And as great as it is for drawing application, have you looked into the larger system you are, for example, kind of guiding the user to the OK button or something like that?
What we're doing right here is technically called motor space manipulation, right? So we're manipulating the user's motor space when they're interacting with the system. And there's been prior work in motor space manipulation in exactly what you're talking about. So the only other work with motor space manipulation for end users in applications has been with targeting tasks. So for example, making it easier to select the default button, or when you're using menus, making it easier for you to hit a submenu without falling off of it. And so people have tried these things, but no one has tried making these end user tools that they can plunk right into a composition.
Well, very cool.